Out at our sediment erosion control lab, we do a lot of research as far as water quality, basically stormwater quality, not drinking water. The EPA has mandated that all stormwater, which is coming off of construction sites, whether you're building a Walmart or if it's for TxDOT building highways, that water has to be clean. They started out by just saying in their construction general permit that you have to use erosion and sediment control products, but they didn't tell you which ones to use or what your target goals for sediment is. They're in discussions right now of setting up a turbidity limit of sediment coming off of these sites. They're talking about the idea of going out to the construction sites and permanent sites and actually taking a physical sample of the stormwater that's being discharged from that site, and it has to fall within certain turbidity limits. And if it doesn't, then they get a chance to mitigate those problems, and then it escalates into fines and other penalties. The way this is going to benefit the public is that it's going to keep the receiving waters clean. You know, it goes from your local ditches there next to the construction site, your swales and ditches, onto the bigger creeks and into the rivers, and eventually feeds the oceans. What this is going to do is really reduce the amount of pollutants that wind up in our receiving waters, which could certainly have negative impact along down the line on wildlife and on personal use also. We've just recently been in negotiations with ASHTO to become a national testing center, as opposed to just testing for TxDOT, which we've been doing for quite a while. And we're also in negotiations with FHWA to start a pool fund program, which is going to allow other state DOTs to have an input at our facility for research priorities and some other benefits of being a part of the pool fund.